Spider Impact is the fastest and easiest way to automate your organization's strategy. It's based around the idea that you improve what you measure. I'm going to give you a quick demo of the software by showing you how three different types of people would use it. So if I were a typical employee, I'd care a lot about this home screen that you see when you first log in. Here in alerts, I can see that product costs has taken a turn for the worse, and I can click on it to drill down, but I see that I also have some responsibilities over here. I'm responsible for updating 3 KPIs, I own 10 KPIs, and I own 2 tasks. So let's take a look at KPI updates. Now, you'll often have Spider Impact wired up so that it's automatically pulling values from your spreadsheets and databases, but there are times when you're going to need to manually update values, and these are the 3 I'm responsible for. So every month, I'm going to log in and update the values for product revenue and training revenue and book revenue. And finally, I'm going to go to My KPIs. If you're using Spider Impact with balanced scorecard language, it's going to be called My Measures, but it's the same thing with a different name. This is the screen that shows you everything you want to keep an eye on. You can click a filter on the top to just show the red ones. Now, keep in mind that I'm already getting alerts the second any of these turn red, but it's nice to have the home screen as a place to go to get an overall feel for how everything's performing. Another type of person who'd use Spider Impact is a high-level executive. They're going to spend a lot of time in this bookmark section, where they can click through their top 5 or 6 screens that they really care about and then move on with their job. So here we've got our strategy map where we can see our corporate strategy at a glance. We can see here the improve knowledge and skills objective isn't doing so hot, but it is improving since last month. Over here we've got a sales pipeline dashboard where we can see ad clicks that go into leads and new trials and new customers. We can see that we've improved on leads recently, but new customers is still a problem area. Or this sales versus expenses dashboard. Here we can see our 3 main revenue areas, and also our 4 cost areas, like book production costs or product costs. Here at the bottom, we have operating expenses broken down into 10 KPIs, like travel or insurance. This dashboard shows us the effects of IT initiatives. Here we have some KPIs like network availability or IT effectiveness index, and we also have 2 initiatives that we've put in place to improve these KPIs, and you can track their performance over time with both cost and schedule. But it's not just dashboards and strategy maps. We also have this red measures report that shows me every single red KPI in the system. Or we can take a closer look at this migrate servers to the cloud initiative. Spider Impact has some really smart algorithms that help predict whether your initiative is going to be on time and under budget. And here we can see we're going to be 21 days late, but we're going to be slightly under budget. If we scroll down, we can see the initiative's performance over time. And here's the 2 items that we've said are related to this initiative: ad clicks and improve IT effectiveness. Now, ad clicks doesn't seem to be affected by this initiative, and that makes sense. Why would your advertising have anything to do with migrating servers to the cloud? But this initiative does seem to be improving IT effectiveness. We don't have to take the software's word for it, though. Let's click the button to see what's going on. As you can see, Spider Impact is doing some real statistics here, and it's showing its work. Our Migrate Servers to the Cloud initiative is definitely correlated with an improvement to IT effectiveness. So that's high-level executives. They're going to click through their bookmarks in the morning and maybe analyze a few things that grab their attention. They're using the software to get a good overview of how the organization is performing strategically. A third type of person who'd use Spider Impact is a power user. Rather than clicking through bookmarks, they're going to dig into the software to visit the actual sections. So we'll start with scorecards. And now for the first time, we have to choose an organization. This is my company's org tree, and every organization can have a different scorecard or dashboards. We're going to choose the root organization, Mobile World Inc., and we see our corporate balance scorecard broken into the 4 perspectives. You can expand any of them by clicking on them and see the objectives and measures. Everything here, you can see the performance over time, and it has a score against a goal, and that score is rolled up the tree. In the initiative section, we've seen this Migrate Servers to the Cloud initiative, But here's another search engine optimization capability initiative that we haven't seen. It's 14 days early and quite a bit under budget, but what's really neat is all of its cost and schedule data is being derived from the actions and milestones underneath. And then there's the files section. You can upload documents and PDF files here in support of your KPIs and link them as related items, but you can also upload images to use as backgrounds for your dashboards or strategy maps, or even your company's logo. Speaking of strategy maps, let's look at the four presentation sections. We've seen this strategy map before, but what we haven't done is click on something to drill down for more information. And it takes you right into the scorecard section to see everything that's going on behind the scenes. Here's the dashboard section, and we've seen this before, but what we haven't seen is a call center status dashboard. These are all scorecard items that are scored, but this is a third-party data widget. You can use it to embed all kinds of content from other apps, and in this example, we're doing Google Maps. In charts and reports, we've seen this red measures report before, but here's downward trending measures, everything that's performing worse this month than last month. And finally is the briefing section. Once you've put together all your dashboards and reports, you can assemble them into a single briefing and lead meetings that way. It's a lot like PowerPoint, except the data is live. If someone asks you a question about new customers, you can just click to drill down right into the scorecard section to see what's going on. And this whole time, there's a notice on top saying your briefing is paused. Just click to jump right back in and continue your briefing. So that's Spider Impact. It's performance management software that brings your strategy to life.